State run Ceylon Electricity Board will connect the northern Jaffna Peninsula to the national grid on September 25th with the commissioning of a power line to the north, the CEB said. Tamil Tiger separatists had destroyed two power lines running from Vavuniya to Kilinochchi and Vavuniya to Mena in October 1987, just as an Indian peacekeeping force started an offensive, Power and Energy Minister Champika Ranawaka said. Resettled war refugees were given power free for an year.
වර්ෂයකට යාපනයේ වාසය කරන එක පවුලක විදුලිය සඳහා විදුලි බල මණ්ඩලෙ රුපියල් 20,000 ගානේ දරනවා. අසාධාරණය ගැන කතා කරන අයට මේක හොඳ උත්තරයක්. අපි බොහොම අමාරුවෙන් මේ කටයුත්ත කරගෙන යන්නේ. මේ රටේ අනිකුත් ජනතාවගේ බදු මුදල් වලින් අපි මේක කරගෙන යන්නේ. ඉතින් ඒ වගේ තත්ත්වයක් තියෙනවා. නමුත් දැන් අපේ අපිට ආධාර ලැබුණ පළවෙනි පියවර යාපනයේට විදුලිය සම්පාදනය කිරීම සහ උතුරු පළාතේ විදුලිය අනුපාතය වැඩි දියුණු කිරීම සඳහා අපි මේ වෙනකොට වන්නේ සෑම ප්‍රදේශයකටම පාහේ 33 kV මධ්‍ය ප්‍රමාණ අධිසර මාර්ගය අරන් ගිහින්. කොටින් අපි දැන් සැලසුම් කරලා තියෙනවා යුද්ධයේ අවසාන වකවානුව තිබිච්ච නන්දිකඩාල් කලපුව අසලින් යන පුතුමාතලන් වෙල්ලමුල්ල වයිකල් ඒ තීරුවත් යාකරන්න. ඒ තීරුවෙත් විදුලි බලය සපයන්න. දැනට අපි කුතුකුඩු රුක්කුවට විදුලිය ගෙනihin තියෙනවා මුලතිව් වලට විදුලිය ගෙනihin තියෙනවා. ඉතින් ඒ අනුව ප්‍රධාන ජනාවාස සියල්ලම අපි ආවරණය කරලා තියෙනවා.
The main opposition UNP said that they are confident of winning any national level election in the coming years as the favor of the people to the existing government is diminishing.
තුනකින් ජනාධිපතිවරයට යනකොට ආණ්ඩුව තව කඩා වැටෙනවා තව බිඳ වැටෙනවා අනිත් දිස්ත්‍රික්කවල ඒගොල්ලන්ට තියෙන වාසිය ඒ ගැප් එක අඩු වෙනවා ස්ථිර වශයෙන් ඒ නිසා අපි පැහැදිලිව ආණ්ඩුවට අභියෝග කරනවා පුළුවන් නම් තව අවුරුදු දෙකක් තුනක් ඇතුළත පුළුවන් නම් ජාතික මැතිවරණයට ගිහිල්ලා පෙන්වන්න අපි ස්ථිර වශයෙන්ම මේ දිස්ත්‍රික්ක 10 ජයග්‍රහණය සමග මේ ආණ්ඩුවේ මැති අමතිවරු තව 50ක් විතර විපක්ෂයේ ඉඳවලා අපි අපේ ජාතික මැතිවරණය ජයග්‍රහණය කරලා පෙන්නනවා කියලා අපි පැහැදිලිව මේ ආණ්ඩුවට අභියෝග කරනවා.
In that scenario,
Sri Lanka has to keep inflation in mid-single digits to allow the economy to grow towards $100 billion by 2016, with GDP at 8% a year, as targeted by authorities, the central bank governor Ajit Niwad Kabral said.
If you are to achieve $100 billion economy, what would be the parameters that we should be looking at? Let me share some of those thoughts with you. Initially, we'll have to be looking at a per capita income of just below $5,000. We will need to see that our inflation is maintained at mid-single digit levels, which was the mantra that we have been working on during the last 43 months.
Kabral was speaking at an economic forum organized by Bloomberg Newswires.
The significance of that sometimes is not realized by many people. When you say that we have had 43 months of single-digit inflation, because the only other period that is of some comparison was a period of 23 months only when we had single-digit inflation in the early 2000s. Other than that, Sri Lanka has been traditionally a country with high inflation, and we had almost come to feel comfortable with 10, 12, 15, 20% inflation. I remember talking to some investors abroad, and when they asked me, how come you have had such high inflation? I said, perhaps we have got used to having a temperature of 104 degrees and living with it. But when you get to normal temperatures, you'll realize how important it is to have a normal temperature. And today, people are beginning to realize what it means to have reasonable inflation for a country that is growing fast and not to go too much beyond that.
Inflation has moved briefly above mid-single digits in the past few months, peaking at 9.8% in July after the rupee fell from 110 to 134 to the US dollar due to balance of payments trouble brought on by sterilized foreign exchange sales. After growing around 8% for 2 years, Sri Lanka's economic growth is expected to slow this year to around 7% or less. Cabral said Sri Lanka would return to the higher growth path from next year with 8% or 8% plus GDP levels.
In that scenario, what will you probably see? We would see an 8% growth being regained by Sri Lanka. This year, as you would have seen, we have had to curtail growth to some extent in order to make the necessary adjustments to bring the stability and to maintain stability. Of course, it is not a major change, but a 1% cut perhaps in our growth levels. But we would see that returning from next year onwards so that we can get back to the 8% or 8% plus growth.
The Institute of Chartered Accountants of Sri Lanka Thursday granted associate membership status to 215 finalists who passed out from the institute. The ceremony was held at the Water's Edge Colombo.
Spent 299 days in space flying 20.
Space Shuttle Endeavour will spend its last flying day Friday not rocketing into space, but doing what most tourists do when visiting California. In what promises to be a crowd-rousing air show, Endeavour, strapped atop a 747 jumbo jet, will take off after sunrise from Edwards Air Force Base in the US and dip low over various landmarks in a 4.5-hour sightseeing flight before landing at the Los Angeles International Airport. This will be the shuttle's last aerial flight before it spends its retirement years as a museum piece.
Front moving over Texas delayed its departure until Wednesday. It's now going to spend 2 days in Houston before flying to its retirement home in California.
Attention students!
Glee is waiting for you.
The fourth season of the Fox musical comedy drama television series Glee premiered last week. The television series was commissioned on April 9, 2012. It is produced by 20th Century Fox Television with Ryan Murphy Television and Brad Falchuk Television as executive producers. The series features the New Directions Glee Club at the fictional William McKinley High School in the town of Ohio will take. The fourth season continues in Lima but will also follow some of McKinley's graduates from the third season, notably to the fictional New York Academy of Dramatic Arts. As the season premiere, 13 main cast members are retaining that status from the third season.
Season premiere tomorrow after the X Factor on Fox.
Looks like you guys have been officially welcomed to the Glee Club.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook.